Hi everyone, welcome to Bodyworks Prime. Today we're going over the origin, the insertion and the action of the Flexor Digitorum Profundus.
Highlighted in green here, we can see the Flexor Digitorum Profundus muscle. And because it's a relatively deep muscle of the forearm, it's covered up by other muscles. The primary muscle covering this is the Flexor Digitorum Superficialis. I've highlighted the Flexor Digitorum Superficialis here in green. One thing to note about the profundus is that it actually passes through a little gap that the superficialis has at the distal portion of the muscle. Let's swap to a different view so we can take a bit of a closer look at that. Here we can see the Flexor Digitorum Superficialis by itself, and now you can better see those gaps which the Flexor Digitorum Profundus muscle passes through. And I've brought the Flexor Digitorum Profundus back into view, and you can see now how it's passing through those gaps which we just saw before. Now we can see just the Flexor Digitorum Profundus by itself. If you'd like to learn more about the Flexor Digitorum Superficialis though, I've got a video on that, and I'll put a link in the description box below, so check that out afterwards if you're interested. Let's take a look at the origins next. Now we can see the origin point here, highlighted in red, and let's go over the anatomical terminology so that we can describe where it's originating from. So this bone here would be the radius, and this bone here would be the ulna. And you'll notice that the red section that's highlighted is towards the medial side, so medial would be towards the midline of the body, and it's also on the front of the ulna, the side of the ulna that's facing us, so that would be the anterior side. So if we were going to describe the origin point of this muscle, we'd say it's originating on the upper three quarters of the anterior and medial surfaces of the ulna. We can see our next origin point here now, highlighted in red. That's going to be on the interosseous membrane. So the interosseous membrane is a thick and dense sheet of connective tissue that connects onto the radius here and the ulna, and it's between these two bones. And as the Flexor Digitorum Profundus muscle passes down the arm here, it's going to cross over onto this interosseous membrane in this portion here, and then that's going to serve as another origin point for this muscle. So let's zoom in on the hand so that we can see the insertion points of the Flexor Digitorum Profundus muscle. You can see them here highlighted in blue. That's going to be on the palmar surface of the distal phalanges of digits 2 through 5. So obviously this would be digit 2, 3, 4 and 5. The palmar surface would be the side of the hand that's facing us here. And I'll just put a little diagram on the screen here so that you can see all of the different bones and joints of the fingers and their names. And you can see that it's originating on the distal phalanges, so that's the tip of the finger.
So let's take a look at the actions next. Now the first and primary action of the Flexor Digitorum Profundus is flexion of the fingers, but let's take a look at that in a little bit more detail.
On the right you can see I've labelled all of the joints of the fingers, and the Flexor Digitorum Profundus is able to cause flexion at all three of those joints: the distal interphalangeal joint, the proximal interphalangeal joint, and the metacarpophalangeal joint. Compare that to its close relation, the Flexor Digitorum Superficialis. The Flexor Digitorum Superficialis doesn't cross the distal interphalangeal joint at the tip of the finger, so the Flexor Digitorum Superficialis can't cause flexion of that joint, whereas the Flexor Digitorum Profundus can. The Flexor Digitorum Profundus is also able to provide weak assistance during flexion of the wrist. However, its primary action is flexion of the fingers.
So if you've enjoyed the video or you find it helpful, you know which buttons to press. Press that like, subscribe, let me know what you thought of the video in a comment. It really helps out the channel. Thanks again for watching everyone. See you all next time.